and are moved to give you praise and to move and are moved to make a decision to follow you. God, it's in your name we pray. Amen. Amen. Listen, we are so thankful for you being with us today. If this is your first time and you're watching on Facebook Live, we just simply want you to text the word new, the number 2, W-O-F. So that's N-E-W, the number 2, W-O-F, to 84576. That's just our greeting of you. We're greeting you and we're thanking you for joining us. We're thanking you for joining us. If you're our first time guest, text new, the number 2, W-O-F, to 84576. We're so thankful for you joining us today. We don't take it for granted. We don't take it for granted. Let's jump into God's word right now. If you have your Bibles, know we're in this series. We are one Sunday away from completing this series, The Journey Continues. So today, we're going to pick up where we've left off, and we are in the book of Joshua, chapter number 5. Joshua, chapter number 5, and I'm just going to read the first 9 verses. Joshua, chapter number 5. Joshua, chapter number 5, the first 9 verses. It says this: So it was, when all the kings of the Amorites who were on the west side of the Jordan and all the kings of the Canaanites who were by the sea heard that the Lord had dried up the waters of the Jordan from before the children of Israel until we had crossed over, that their heart melted and there was no spirit in them any longer because of the children of Israel. At that time, the Lord said to Joshua, make flint knives for yourselves and circumcise the sons of Israel again the second time. So Joshua made flint knives for himself and circumcised the sons of Israel at the hill of the foreskins. And this is the reason why Joshua circumcised them. All the people who came out of Egypt who were males, all the men of war, had died in the wilderness on the way, after they had come out of Egypt. For all the people who came out had been circumcised, but all the people born in the wilderness on the way as they came out of Egypt had not been circumcised. For the children of Israel walked 40 years in the wilderness till all the people who were men of war who came out of Egypt were consumed because they did not obey the voice of the Lord, to whom the Lord swore that he would show them the land which the Lord had sworn to their fathers that he would give us, a land flowing with milk and honey. Then Joshua circumcised their sons whom he raised up in their place, for they were uncircumcised because they had not been circumcised on the way. So it was, when they had finished circumcising all the people, that they stayed in their place till they were healed. Then the Lord said to Joshua, this day I have rolled the reproach of Egypt from you. Therefore, the place is now called Gilgal to this day. Now, let's go back up. It says, make flint knives for yourselves and circumcise the sons of Israel the second time. I want to preach today from this thought, starting over in the same place. Starting over in the same place. Oftentimes, we believe that in order to start over, in order to start from scratch, we have to be in a different place. We have to be in a different location. We got to move where nobody knows us, where no one has a history of us. We got to go to see new things. And we believe that starting over is attributed to a new location. But there are times when God forces us to start over in the same place. There are times when God forces us to go back to where we began in order to start over. That start over could be synonymous with a fresh start, because the reality is you should be different when you start over. You should be different when you start over. And that's where we find ourselves today in the text. The children of Israel are on the other side of the Jordan in Canaan. They're in Canaan, which is the promised land. Now, the beautiful thing that you may not realize is, though they're in Canaan now, this is not the first time the children of Israel have been in Canaan. If you remember, Canaan was first entered by Abram. Abram was promised Canaan in Genesis chapter 12. And now we're in We're in Joshua chapter 5. And finally, they're back again in Canaan. they're back again in Canaan, but this time they're now able to start again in the same place. I don't know who I'm talking to, but some of you have been waiting to start over until you changed your address. You've been waiting to start over until you changed your boo. You've been waiting to start over until you changed your job. But I'm here to tell you that sometimes there's a blessing in starting over right where you are. In other words, starting over isn't predicated on anything new. It's simply predicated on you deciding that it's time to start over. And I don't know who I'm talking to, but today should be your declaration of independence from your yesterday. It should be your declaration of independence from your past. It should be your declaration of independence from your pain. It should be your declaration of independence from your failure. It should be your declaration of independence from your fall. It should be your declaration of independence from whatever pain there is associated with your past. For this day, this day, we are starting over in the same place. So the question is, what's so special about starting over in the same place? Here's the first thing. The first thing that's so special about starting over in the same place is that our success will silence those who may have said differently. Oh my God. Our success will silence those who may have said differently. You may not catch it. Let me tell you what the text begins with. The text begins with by saying that there were two groups that were watching the Jordan dry up. There were the Amorites and the Canaanites. The Amorites come from the word Amor, which means to say. Those are the sayers. Those are the people that be popping junk. Those are the people that gossip and talk about all you've been through and how you never recover. But those are the people who had to watch you cross. Oh, man. Then there were the Canaanites. The Canaanites were there that were already there. Those were the natives of the land. Those are the people that were there the first time they came through. Remember, the first time they came through, in Numbers, they believed that the giants were so big that they saw themselves as grasshoppers, so they didn't conquer. And they had to wait 40 years until they had this opportunity. There are some people that have been with you but still didn't believe you would amount to anything. Oh, man. There are some people that grew up with you that are native. They know you, know all about you. Walker, they know your past. Harrison, they know when you was growing up, and they don't believe you're going to be nothing. But you need to say that if you start over in the same place, those people have to witness. Ha! They become witnesses of your growth. They become witnesses of your development. And all they can say is, look at them now. Oh, man. Oh, man. Oh, man. Listen. So they'll be silent. In fact, the text says that because they watched what happened, their heart was taken. Their courage was taken. In fact, they were punked. That's how we say it in the street. They were punked. They got punked because they thought that they couldn't make it till they watched them make it. Oh, man. And sometimes, let me just tell you, stop worrying about your haters. Sometimes God allows front row seats to your haters to watch you make it so he can shut them up. Oh, man, I know that's a harsh word, but sometimes God has to shut the mouth of those who don't believe you can be who God said you could be. Oh, man. Oh, man. Hold on. Let's keep going. Because not only will your success silence those who may have said differently, here's the second thing. Our obedience opened this opportunity. What's the special thing about starting over? It was our obedience. Catch this. The first time they tried it, they couldn't make it. All right. In fact, the first two times they tried it. Okay, maybe you don't remember. Remember, Abram was told to take his wife and leave his father's house and go to this place that God was sending him. He went, but he took Lot with him. And because he took Lot with him, he couldn't understand and benefit from the full breadth of Canaan because he had to split the land. Fast forward, the children of Israel were told to go take 10 spies, 12 spies, and go look at the land I'm about to give you. 10 of them came back with an issue. Two of them believed. As a result, 40 years they had to wander, and everybody 20 years and older had to die. That was disobedience. Oh, man, listen, but now they've gotten it right. Now they've believed. Now when the spies went out, guess what? They came back with a good report. Now when they were told to cross over, they didn't bicker and moan. They just did what the Lord said. And now their obedience has opened the opportunity for them to occupy God's land. Oh, man, listen, I need to tell you that when you start new, don't mess up like you did the last time. When you get a fresh start, when you get a new opportunity, when you get to start over, even if it's in the same place, be obedient this time. Oh, man, because your obedience will offer opportunities for you to truly occupy. Oh, man, listen, because if you mess up, all you do is have to repeat it. And God says, you wasted too much time repeating already, that now is time to occupy, and your occupation of the land is based solely on your obedience. Oh man, oh man. Here's number three. I gotta keep going. So what's so special about starting over? Not only will your success silence those who may have said something differently, not only will your obedience open the opportunity for your occupation, but number three, we may be at the same place, but we definitely ain't the same people. Oh God, listen, they're on the other side of the Jordan, but now they're 3 million strong. Woo, golly, it was just Abram, Lot, and Sarai back the first time. It was just the 12 spies the second time. It was just the 2 spies the third time, but now they're 3 million deep, and they're ready to occupy the land. And you need to understand that even though you're starting over in the same place, you're in a whole nother season of your life. You've been through some things. You've encountered some things. You've learned to appreciate some things. And because you can appreciate it, you'll steward it better. You'll handle it differently. Anybody here testify? I got fired the first time, but when I got that second job, I showed up to work on time. I didn't go to work drunk from the night before. No, no, no. I didn't take a 2-hour lunch. No, I took my 30-minute break, my 2:15 breaks, and I did what I was supposed to do, because if I got a second chance, I'm not going to mess it up by doing the same thing I did to lose it the first time. Oh, man. And you need to understand that the reason God is giving you this opportunity to start over is because God is expecting you to start over with a new attitude. He's expecting you to start over and leave the baggage of your yesterday in yesterday. Oh, God, remember, we just dealt with the stones. We left those memories at Gilgal. And now we're ready to move forward, because we got to let some stuff go. And the only way you're going to be able to enjoy this second chance, this second opportunity, this starting over in the same place, is if you don't act the same. So listen, I could have said same place, but not the same people. I should have said same place, but not the same attitude. Same place, but not the same practices. Same place, but not the same mindset. Same place, but not the same behaviors. Because we're moving differently in this new season. Here's the fourth thing. Hold on. What's so special about starting over? It's the right time to renew our relationships. It's the right time to renew our relationships. Man, listen what it says. It says, God told Joshua to sharpen your flint knives and circumcise everybody a second time. Oh, catch this. Catch this. God says, since you're in this new place, I don't care about their prior status. We're going to make sure everybody gets circumcised. Because first of all, you need to strengthen or renew your relationship with me. That's what God says. Because circumcision was a sign of covenant. It was a sign of relationship. And God says, y'all have messed up so much in the past that this is the perfect time to start from scratch. And I'm telling you, in the beginning of us starting new, it's so imperative that we rebuild our relationship to God. That's why we have the morning prayer line. And I'm so appreciative of the fact that every morning at least 14 to 17 people get on. But you know what? There's room for so many more. I know it's a sacrifice, but God says in this new season, you got to do things a new way. You got to get up at 5:45, 5:40 if it takes you that long to get your mind together so you can see the numbers on the phone pad and dial them in and not dial the wrong number. It may take you a couple times, but you wake up, because in your waking up, you're renewing your relationship with God. Hold on. Because it's not just that. Hold on. Because then there's relationship with others. Because here's the reality. Everybody getting cut. Oh, God. Everybody getting cut. Which means ain't going to be some people not cutting. Other people's waving in their face that I ain't cutting. No, everybody getting cut. Which means everybody going to be going through the same pain. And that's transition. The reality is transition is a pain for everybody. All of us are going through. But rather than be separate and holding it in, this provides us the space to talk to each other, because we're all going together, which means our relationships should be growing. Oh, man. Because here's the thing. We're learning stuff about each other. We're learning how we handle pain. Oh, man. Oh, man. Because we've been walking around for the last 40 years. These Israelites, they've been walking around for the last 40 years, hadn't been thinking about circumcision. So even those who were circumcised, who were 8 days up to 19 years, 40 years ago, they don't remember the pain of circumcision. So everybody's going through the pain because it's pain. I mean, I was the newborn, so I don't remember, but I can only imagine being a grown man with no anesthetic. It's a pain. But they were all going to go through that pain together. And it's in going through together that relationships are built. I'm in the military, and my unit just went through advanced training, which was 15 days of living together, bunking together, working together without interruption from outside influences. And even those that didn't like each other on day one were being best friends on day five. They became each other's battle, because sometimes you don't get to know each other till you go through some stuff together. Sometimes you don't get to learn the intricacies of another person's personality until you walk. Listen, you can date somebody 37 years, but there's something about getting married to them and having to live with them and wake up with them and grocery shop together and get to the last roll of toilet paper and figure out which way it goes on the roll, or figure out which way to fold a towel. Do you fold them in threes or do you fold them in half? That determines, oh man, hold on. Do you put sugar on your grits or do you put salt on your grits? That's what determines the strength of a relationship. It comes after going through some stuff together. Hold on, I got to keep pushing. Because the stripping away of skin, number five, makes us the same. Oh man, text says everybody got to get circumcised. Not just those who got circumcised in Egypt before, but also those who were born in the wilderness and never got it. Catch this. Some people, oh God, some people think because they've been somewhere a long time, they don't have to go through the same process, and they alienate those who've only been there a little bit of time. But God says this shared stripping away of skin, this circumcision, is going to make sure everybody goes through, and that puts everybody on the same playing field. Oh, no matter whether you've been only a minute, or whether you've been a member for a month, 2 months, or 3 years, or you've been here since August 4th, 1996, in this new season, there's about to be a circumcision of everybody. Okay, let me tell you what it is. Just give you a preview. Beginning in September, for the month of September, October, November, and December, we're about to launch the Faith Academy. The Faith Academy is going to be what will evolve into our added members course, but it will be taken now by every member of the Word of Faith family. Every member, whether you've been here since the beginning, even Bishop and Pastor Anita are going to take the Faith Academy. Why? Because we need to be on level playing field moving forward. We need to be learning the same thing, speaking the same language, attuned to the same thought process moving forward. So we're going to start in September with identity. Who does God say that I am? Then we're going to move to expectation in October. What does God want from me? Then we're going to move to assignment in November. What does God want me to do based on who God sees me as? And then in December, we're going to deal with commitment. What is the cost of giving God all I have? And then after that, we're going to be consecrated together at the end of the year as faith walkers. And then we're going to start the year with our new theme for 2021. You ready? Faith walking forward into our future. Catch that. So we're going to learn to be faith walkers in September, October, November, December, and we're going to walk out our faith in January through 2021. Oh, man. Which means, listen, we all got to learn it. All of us got to be circumcised. We all, whether you've been circumcised or whether you ain't got your skin cut yet, we all getting cut together, because that's the only way for us to move forward without the hierarchy and cliques and disengagement and disenfranchisement of those who were here from the beginning versus those who are just coming on. We're going to all be together moving forward. Oh, man. Oh, why? Here's number six. I'm almost done. We do that so that we can now create a culture of covenant. Oh, catch this. The reason this circumcision was so important and was implemented back in Genesis was to be the sign of the covenant between God and Abraham. God and Abraham made this covenant, and this covenant was that God was going to walk with Abraham and all of Abraham's descendants. But somehow, in the brink of captivity in Egypt, also versus this idea of losing the knowledge of God, to the point that when I get freed from Egypt, I then want to create a golden calf because that's the God I need. And so when God writes on the tablets for Moses, Moses then breaks the tablets, which ends up breaking the covenant. And so now they're reestablishing the covenant. Oh man, listen. And so God says this circumcision is needed so that we now can create a culture for covenant within the congregation. Catch this, because it's not just about being connected to God, it's about being connected to each other. In other words, we all go through when one goes through. When Deacon Harrison is going through, we all hurt. When Dr. Frazier's going through, we all hurt. When Elder Walker's going through, we all hurt. And we're covenanted to each other, which means I ain't moving forward till we all moving forward. I ain't leaving you behind because I'm covenanted to you. I'll be your strength when you are weak. And when I am weak, you got to be my strength. We got to walk through this thing that God says, listen, before y'all go into this promised land, ain't going to be no more divisions. We got to be ride or die together. So I'm cutting everybody because everybody needs to be cut so that they can heal together. Oh, God, they got to all be broken so they can heal together. God wants us to heal together so that we can walk hand in hand together into the fullness of this promised land. Oh, man. Oh, man. Oh, man. Listen, you got to understand that the reason we're going through and the reason we're getting the ability to start over in the same place is so that we can walk stronger as a result of this starting over. And there will be nothing that can stop us if we all work together. Here, I'm done. What's so special about starting over? Here's the last thing, and I'm done. Starting over gives us a perspective shift. This Gilgal goes from being the place of the past to the precipice of possibility. Oh, see, we just learned that they put the stones there in chapter 4. But in verse 9 of chapter 5, look at what he says. He says, now the shame of Egypt has been revoked. It's been rolled back. And they named this place Gilgal. Gilgal means wheel in the Hebrew. And it literally means that everything that plagued you since your Egyptian captivity has now been reversed. The weak people you saw yourself as when you're looking in Numbers 13 has now been replaced with the strength you see in the God who helped you cross over. In other words, listen, we can't see ourselves as we saw ourselves because we are no longer who we were. I'm telling you, from this point on, and I'm done, when you look in the mirror, you need to see strength. When you look in the mirror, you need to seem blessed. When you look in the mirror, you need to see hope. When you look in the mirror, you need to see possibility. When you look in the mirror, you need to see promise, not because of who you are, but because of who God is. Because now we're back in covenant with God, which means there's nothing we can't accomplish. Because if God said it, it will come to pass. If we pray about it, God will make it possible. If we walk in the path God laid for us, there is nothing that can be withheld from us because God has us. And all I'm trying to say before I take my seat and I'm done is that from now on, we have to see ourselves through the lens God sees us. That's going to lead us to next week. So next week, as we're in the parking lot closing out this series, we're going to see what the sound of unity is. And the sound of unity that was constructed through circumcision at the edge of the Jordan River is the sound that tears down walls. It's the sound that gives victory. It's the sound that releases the ability to acquire what God has for us. All that comes from the sound of unity. So we're cut together here. We'll heal together this week. And we'll sound like one band, one sound on Sunday and watch walls fall down. Watch opportunity come. Watch possibility be present. All because we're starting over in the same place. Let's give God a hand of praise. Let's give God a hand of praise. Listen, we are not going to be who we were. Who we were worked then, but who we are going to be won't happen if we still work like who we were. That's why God closed the Jordan. That's why Joshua buried those 12 stones. And that's why we're able to stand with our memory stones planted in Gilgal facing Jericho, because who we will be is not like who we were. So today, as we get ready to connect with everybody on here and give opportunity for connection, I simply want to remind you before I pray that you need to know this, that you determine how successful your starting over is, even if it's in the same place. And you determine that by declaring that you will not be who you were. Who you were worked for then, but what you need for who you will be is a new you that comes through a new connection with Christ through a fresh circumcision. God needs to cut off all that developed in your wilderness season. God needs to cut off everything that grew as you were surviving in the wilderness, because you're not in the wilderness anymore. For the first time, manna's not going to be necessary anymore. For the first time, water ain't got to come from rocks anymore, because now you're in the place where your newness is about to come, but you can't mismanage your newness acting like you did when you were in the wilderness. Let's pray. God, we thank you for fresh starts. We thank you for this ability to start over, even if in the same place. We're so thankful that while we're in the same place, we're not in the same season. Even though we're in the same place, we're not the same people. We're so thankful that we've learned some lessons in the wilderness that will now help us to be better stewards of the promise you have for us. Give us strength to walk boldly, unashamedly, unapologetically, unbridled and unbothered into the newness of your possibility and promise for us. It's in your name we pray. Amen. Listen, it's connection time. It's connection time. First way I want you to connect is I want you to connect with us on all social media. I want you to connect us on all social media using at WOFCJC events. That's Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, and Twitter. You can connect with us on all those. We're still working to build our YouTube channel. We need 30 more subscribers to be able to name it the same way. Not only do we want you to connect with us on social media, but we want you, if this is your first time viewing with us, to connect to us as a first-time guest. That means you're going to text the word new, the number 2, WOF, to 84576. Again, that's 84576. That's new guest. New guest. If that's you, new, the number 2, WOF. And then, if you need to connect to Christ, if you've never been saved, and you hear God telling you it's time to give your life to Christ, then simply text the word new faith to 84576. Or if you strayed away from God and you hear God telling you it's time to come back home, then text new faith to 84576. Or if you want to become a member, virtual or in person, of the Word of Faith Church, if you want to be part of the Word of Faith Church online or the Word of Faith Church Riverdale, simply text new faith to 84576. All those connections. And then here's the next thing. If you want to be connected to a kingdom helper, to our kingdom team, if you are a member but have not connected to a ministry, we need you to text HELPS, H-E-L-P-S, to 84576, H-E-L-P-S, to 84576. And finally, it's our opportunity to connect through contribution. You can give today. You can sow a seed into the Word of Faith Church, especially if this word has added value to your life. You can do that by going to www.razmobile.com/WOFC or going to givelify.com and searching for Word of Faith Church in Riverdale, Maryland. You can mail it to 6001 66th Avenue, number 101, Riverdale, Maryland, or you can give using Cash App. Pull your Cash App out, go to Cash Tag, Word of Faith CJC. That should be cash tag. That should be $ Word of Faith CJC. Make sure you give. You don't want to leave this worship experience without the opportunity to sow into this moment. This is fertile ground, and this ground will yield harvest. Let's pray over this offering and then give the benediction. God, we thank you for the opportunity to give. We bless your name, God. We bless your name, God. We bless your name, God, for all the gifts you bestowed to us. God, we simply ask you to take this portion back and use it to build your kingdom. God, multiply it as only you can. In your name we pray. And then, God, as we leave this place, we simply ask that you allow us to repeat your words in Romans 8:31. And what shall we then say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? We love you. Amen. Amen.